Some residents in Pahoa are moving out. Good evening, I'm Yanji Denise. The lava from Kilauea is about a mile and a half from Apa'a Street, and that's where longtime Pahoa resident Chuck Cullen lives. He's packed up and isn't taking any chances. Civil defense officials observe the flow continuing to head in a northeast direction in the northwest portion of Ka'ohe Homesteads. The flow front has reached the boundary of the thick forest and is now on more open ground. Over the last 2 days, it has advanced an average of 660 feet per day. Geologists project that lava could reach Apa'a Street in 13 days and to Pahoa Village Road within 18 days and onto Highway 130 in 21 days. KITV4's Cam Tran takes a look at this dynamic lava flow.
Concerned and anxious residents packed Pahoa High School to hear the latest lava update, and the news not very comforting.
In general, the lava flow path, based on the slope of the ground, is going to take the lava flow down through this way, right past the transfer station, and then down through the middle of Pahoa to the north of the post office.
Scientists at the Hawaii Volcano Observatory say there is a high rate of lava pumping from the Pu'u'o vent into the lava tube leading to Pahoa.
The height of those lava level in those ponds really has not changed. It's been very, very stable, which means that lava is coming into Pu'u'o and it's going right through that vent, the fissure, into the lava tube system.
And right now there are no breaks in the lava tube that could divert the fiery flow somewhere else.
In this case, this lava tube is very, very stable. The lava flow that passed from Pu'u'o all the way out to here is relatively narrow, which means it traveled a little faster, but also it's a little thicker. So the tube is well insulated, and it's a very efficient way for the lava to get from Pu'u'o all the way out to the flow front.
Scientists say the flow front is very narrow, making it move faster. Cam Tran, KITV 4 News.